We have Roston Chase, man in the match of the first game, available here to speak with you, the media. And I'll just start the first question and then I'll hand the mic around the room. Roston, what do you make of the Ugandan opposition, having seen them play in the tournament so far? And what areas do you think the West Indies need to improve in order to ensure we overcome that opposition?
I just think that it's a World Cup, so you know, you can't underestimate any team. But every team is as strong as any other team, so we just come in to play them full potential. But I just think for us, it's a case where we have to improve our dot ball percentage, especially in the middle overs. But I mean, the pitch is a difficult one that we played on in the first game. So I think it's a case where we just need to don't panic too quickly. Just try to stabilize the middle overs, because we have a lot of power in the back end to kind of make up for it. So it's just a case where we just need to get a few singles more and ones into twos and stuff like that, and then just launch in the back end.
Roston, as we saw yesterday, huge upset. So again, 20 teams all vying for the same goal. So I'm quite sure that maybe a bit of a wake-up call for all teams, that no teams can be taken for granted.
Yeah, well, obviously, as I said, it's a World Cup. Every team has come here to win. So you can't take any team lightly, because even in the first game that we played, we were on the back foot a bit. So it's clear to see that any team can win on the day. So you have to take every game very serious and go out there and play your best game every game.
Roston, a bit about that performance again, winning the player of the match, first game for the team, and of course it was a slightly tricky situation for West Indies also. How much has your, at a personal level, how much has your game evolved from being a forefront player in your test squad to being a regular now in the T20 format? Tell us a bit about the journey and the kind of role that you played in the PNG game. Is that what we are going to see from you for the remainder of the games as well?
Yeah, well, my game was always one I could always rotate the strike and turn over the strike in the middle overs. But I think my game has evolved where I have learned and have been practicing to finish the game in the back end in terms of the power hitting and getting stronger and stuff. So I think that's what really helped my game to evolve. So that's made me a better player, yes.
In the test team, they call you the crisis man. Thus far in your exploits in T20, you've become the crisis man as well. How much are you enjoying that kind of role for this team?
Yeah, well, in my cricketing career, I've always been one to get some hard tasks. So I really cherish the opportunity and the experiences. I mean, obviously it is good to go out there and get an easy job, but I mean, I think that your teammates and the coaches and especially the fans, I think they rate you more and they appreciate you more when you come out of these hard times. So yeah, I just always looking to do good. Even when the pressure is on, I know that once I come out on top, people love me.
Holistically, you have four quality guys on the bench and 11 in the starting 11 as well. Is that kind of an added pressure for players to ensure, you know, each match you probably have to ensure you produce your best, given there are some guys who equally and ready to replace you if things don't go well?
Well, I can't speak for anyone else, but me personally, I just focus on my game. I can't focus on who's on the bench or who's to come in or who may get an opportunity or who may not get opportunity. When I go there, just focusing on doing what is required of me at that point in time to help my team to get over the line in any game. So I just want to go there and enjoy the cricket and try to win every game for my team, and so that at the end of the tournament, we can be the ones lifting the trophy.
On the lighter side, Roston, your celebration. Just tell us about that celebration, the origin of it. We haven't seen it the other day, but tell us a little bit about it.
Yeah, well, it's just a celebration. I mean, you just come up with anything that's on the top of your mind. I mean, as you said, I haven't really done that celebration in a while, so that one is really gone out the window. I just, you know what I mean? You might see something new in this tournament, so I might just pop up in my mind and might just, you know what I mean, give you a little taste.
Sticking to the lighter note a bit, you've got the big hitters before you in the order, big hitters to follow in the order. So Would you, again, do you like competing with them in terms of hitting the big boundaries? We saw you hit a big six as well. So, Roston, is he all about maybe nurdling the ball? Or, of course, we saw that you can hit the big ball as well. But in terms of the big hitters in the squad, is there any complex, like any, maybe for lack of a better word, any complex at all that perhaps you've got such enormous hitters as we saw at the nets right now? People were ducking for cover. Where do you place yourself in this batting order from that perspective?
In terms of hitting a long ball, no, I don't think I can compete with those guys. But I mean, if I get one good, it may go a good distance. But consistently, I don't think I can compete with those guys. So I'm just happy for any six I get. Even if it goes over the rope by an inch, I'm happy with that.
Excellent. Lastly, about the local fan support, of course, West Indies chasing an unprecedented third title here. In terms of the fan support, of course, we saw there were people there in Uganda. We're once again expecting a big crowd. Overall, once the team starts traveling, any message at all for the fans? How do you want them to rally behind West Indies in this event? And any added pressure at all playing on home soil in home conditions? Or is the team cherishing under this, if one might say, extra pressure? Or some people also call it the 12th man support, with the crowd being there, really rallying you around.
Yeah, well, I would expect from the home fans to really rally around the team. I mean, everyone has their own opinion. I may say they think this person should be playing or that person shouldn't be playing. But I just think that is a case where the team is already selected. So whoever's here, just back them 100%. Give them the support. And just, you know what I mean, don't pray for people to fail. Because at the end of the day, if we win, it's going to be the whole Caribbean. It's not going to be one player or two players. It's going to be the whole team and plus the whole Caribbean. So everyone will be celebrating and be happy. So it's just for the home fans to just come and rally behind us and give every player their support. Even if you may not like a certain player, just, you know what I mean, suck it up and just give him that support. And I'm sure when I go there and the fans are giving us that support, it, as you say, it's like a 12th man. It gives you that extra push, that extra boost to just, you know what I mean? You may be tired, but then when you see the fans rallying, it gives you some energy. It's like a Gatorade. So, yeah, I just want them to... Yeah, Powerade, sorry. Yeah, Powerade, not Gatorade, Powerade. Powerade is the best. So, yeah, yeah, I mean, the crowds aren't big as yet, but I mean, once we start to play some good cricket and start to win some more games, I think that the fans should really come out some more and give us the support. We really looking to be the first team to win a trophy on home soil.
Roston, a couple of Ugandan players have you guys as their role models, their idols. From Chris Gayle to Shimron Hetmeyer, they support you all over the world, and I can tell you they are, you are the second team they support after their own nation. And as well, the oldest man in the Ugandan team at 43, Frank Subuga, naming his first son, who is 12 years, Pollard, after Kieron. How emotional is it? I saw the Ugandan players all over you guys at the opening ceremony in Trinidad, and they saw the video of you guys giving them morale to play better and better. How emotional is it playing a team like that, that looks up to you, and a team that is full of role models in the other dugout? And what niceties are you looking to exchange with them?
Yeah, well, it's always good to have people looking up to you and being a role model to people. I mean, as you said, most teams, their second team is West Indies. I mean, it's because of the way we play, and we embrace everyone. We treat everyone with respect and love, so I guess they take to us because of that. So, yeah, they love the way we play, especially with the excitement and the flair. They want to emulate that and be just like us. So, I mean, it's a great feeling to have people looking up to you. So I just want to wish all the teams the best and just go out there and shine your light, because, I mean, look at a guy like Aaron Jones coming from USA. He's not really a big name per se in world cricket, but he's been showing what he can do. So it's just a stage for you to go there and enjoy the cricket and make a name for yourself. So I just want to wish all the teams well. Just go there and put your best foot forward. Not against West Indies, of course, but all the best to the other guys.
Roston, I just want to get in a couple questions from the media in the Caribbean, who obviously are unable to join us here in Guyana. And one, just piggybacking off of that question, how great is it to see that the associate nations are competing at this World Cup?
Yeah, I mean, it's good for cricket. Obviously, the sport cricket, that the teams can be competitive. You don't want to be seeing, especially the fans, paying their money to come in to a stadium to see a game that lasts for an hour where a team get bozo for 40 and then is just finishing. You know what I mean? You want to see a fight right down to the end and have your money's worth at the end of the day. So that's really good for cricket, that even the associate teams can compete with the First Nation teams and give them a fight, or even like Pakistan upset them. So yeah, I just want to see good cricket throughout.
And one more question, and more on a personal level. Would you say that you're fulfilling that Marlon Samuels role, or do you consider it that you're carving out a new role in this West Indies team?
Yeah, I mean, there could only be one Marlon Samuels and one Roston Chase. I mean, if people want to call it the Marlon Samuels role, I have no problem with that. He's won two world titles playing that role, and I mean, being the man in the match in two of the finals. So I have no problem with that tag, but I'm my own player. I mean, I don't see it as his role. I see it as my own role. The coaches, you know what I mean, sit down and spoke to me about the role, and there was no mention of Marlon Samuels. So, but yeah, I don't mind it at all. Once I'm doing what is required of the team, I mean, for the team, and doing it well, I'm happy with that.
Thank you, Roston, and thank you all for joining us this afternoon.
Thanks.